And our first set of lights. Morning everyone, this is John and I'm in my Tesla Model 3 Performance. We've had the update for 2020.36 Top 10 for some time actually, in fairness. And this is my third attempt to record it. So one of the major updates is traffic light recognition. So the car will automatically stop at a red traffic light. Currently still in beta, which means that we have to manually, just need to nip out of autopilot here. Oh yes, car, I'm on the wrong side of the road. Which means that we have to manually confirm our passage through the traffic lights. So even if they're on green, we still have to confirm that it's okay to proceed, which you can do either by the accelerator, just pressing the accelerator, or hitting the down stalk on the right hand stalk. So I'm in town, you see here it picks up the lights, no problems. I'm not in autopilot at the moment, which is why it didn't require confirmation. Just pop us back in to autopilot. And I just thought I'd just take you out just to show you the improvements and changes on the software. Just around town, stopping in 400 feet for traffic lights, which is good because they are red, so I don't need to do anything. They've now changed, so I'll just press down on the stalk to confirm that's okay to proceed. Another one there, lots of lights about. Whoa, big brake there. It's not so keen on all of the parked cars and what have you. Been out a couple of times to test this already. Really had a problem at pedestrian crossings. Not all pedestrian crossings, but some. It's like this one up here, the one I've just passed, it had heart attack at. That one is absolutely fine. That was because it's dropped out of autopilot. So that would explain it, John. So you can see here it renders the lights a lot brighter. They're the lights that it's actually looking at or recognizing. So if you're at a junction where there's multiple lights, it will indicate the ones that it's concentrating on by the brighter signal. Traffic lights stopping. You can see here there's two sets of lights. There's us in green and those in orange. I'm going to have to break out of autopilot here. So it's done that before. I've done that a couple of times and it's been absolutely perfect. It recognises them as two separate sets. Traffic lights ahead are just changing to amber. I've come this way because there's loads of traffic lights. There's loads of pedestrian crossings as well. Pelican crossings and Belisha Beacon type ones. Stopping for the lights. They've just changed from amber to red. Oh, oh car, what are you doing? It thinks we're at the line where we're not. The actual line is the car in front, the Corsa. He's sitting on the line, but yeah, so we're not just going to knock this out of everything. Come on, to steer restricted to 22 for some reason. It thinks we're in 20, we're not. Oh yeah, the other thing that's improved is the speed recognition, although I got that in an earlier update, so I actually had two updates in the same day, which is a first. We're just stopping here. Yeah, so I had the speed sign awareness, which it picks up on the cameras, and that's worked very well around town on local roads, apart from back there where it thinks it was 20. And we're turning right here, so I'll just knock us off autopilot because it won't do this maneuver. Confirm to go through that, okay. Hopefully we'll keep left, which we will. Not going down those. So stopping for a set of lights which actually aren't there. The lights are only on the left hand side of the road, so and now we're braking hard for some reason. Not doing your best, Mr. Tesla. Braking again. It's because the car in front's turning off. Stopping for traffic lights in 400 feet, which we're okay, so I've just confirmed to go through that. Stopping for traffic, just confirmed that's okay. There's another setup here. Stopping for traffic control in 600 feet, so we'll confirm that as well. Hopefully you're seeing this come up on the visualizations. You'll notice there's a green line across the road, so if it's you've confirmed that it's okay to go through, it'll show it in green. If it's going to stop, it'll show it in red. So that's nice. Go down the bypass here because there's some road signs and what have you. So we're in 30, we're coming up to a 40 and a roundabout which we need to stop at. So there's your rendering on your signs, which is all very posh. One of the nice changes that they have introduced is while you're on cruise control, whatever speed you're actually doing when you engage cruise control, it now runs to that speed if you just tap the speed option at the top here. Whereas previously you had to dial it up and down on the thumb wheel on the steering wheel if you wanted to adjust the speed. So here we go into a 50, so it should render those, which it does, and it shows us as a 50, so that is perfect. Although we're creeping along at 30 still. And then it goes into a 40, and what I've noticed, it renders it on screen, but it doesn't adjust the speed. So let's see what happens here. It shows the 40. Dithering a bit. So still in 40, which is correct. Cone City. So let's just see, we're going to exit the 40 in a minute, which I don't think the car's going to see, because it's going to be blocked by lorry, which it was. Just saw the 30 up there, but that's for the side road, even though it now thinks we're in a 30. So that wasn't our road, that's the side road that runs parallel. And then we're coming into national speed limit signs here, which has rendered one of them. Oh, and it has changed as well, so hurrah, but it hasn't actually adjusted the speed. So we'll do it manually. So it recognised it and adjusted it here, even though it didn't adjust it in my actual speed. That's interesting. We've got some more traffic lights coming up here, so we'll see how those react. We drop into a 40 any minute. So just confirm OK for that. Into the 40. Yep, spot on. Got to say the signage is really good in terms of picking up on speed signs. There's only a few instances where it hasn't. Corrective steering applied for my safety. Obviously doesn't like my driving. I can't blame it. So 40 coming up on the left, picks that up. Traffic control, it's picked up. They're all green, so we'll go through those. I confirm that on the stalk. It is 40 all the way up, and then it goes again to national speed limit signs up the top of the hill here. See how that works out. It's going rather well. With time, once there's lots of data gathered from users and feeds back into Tesla, the confirmation to actually go through the lights will change. So these are obscured a little bit by trees. Let's see. It sees one. Oh, it sees both of them. And it does change, but it doesn't change our speed. So let's just do that manually. Yeah, so with the feedback from users using the system, it won't be too long before we end up not having to do the confirmation proceed through the lights, be they red or green. So that'll be good. So we're slowing down because of the traffic, coming into a 30. We'll see the sign hopefully in a minute. Yeah, it's rendered the signs, it's dropped us automatically to 30, which is good. So that's how it should work. You shouldn't need to intervene, but as you've seen on some of the national speed limit options, you do actually have to, even though it picks it up. I'm sure that's GPS data it's using, otherwise it would automatically change my speed here to match the sign that it's showing. Some traffic lights coming up in a minute, plus a load of bins for your visual delectation. Picks up the lights really soon, 600 feet away. So I'll just confirm that. Okay, to go through. Gets a bit wobbly here with its steering because the road just instantly widens. And there we go. Oh, it's not done too bad. Probably because we're only doing 20 mile an hour. So we're still in 30. We're coming up to our national speed limit signs, which will be 60 on this road. It'll render them there. But as you can see, it's still, well, we've now rendered it to 60, but it hasn't adjusted our speed. So basically it's not recognising that as 60, it's using GPS data. One here, although I'm not engaged in autopilot, so not really going to do anything. It's picked up the 30. Into Burton Latimer, those that are interested. Car in front's turning right, just slowing down for him. Yeah, I think we're okay, car. Car's worried that we might hit him, even though there's loads of space. Super. Well, there you go. I think that's enough. I haven't been able to find a stop sign, so I shall go and look for a stop sign that I can actually use auto steer or cruise control up to and see how we get on with that. And I will see you on the next one. All right. Take care. Thanks for watching.